are the 4 points which I was talking about. You have the end-systolic volume and the end-diastolic volume with the opening and closing of the aortic valve, and the point between B and D is called the stroke volume. So mitral stenosis is characterized by inability of the mitral valve to open completely. So the latency period is 20 years between the initial rheumatic fever and the onset of the disease process. The normal area of the mitral valve is 4 to 6 square centimeter, and patients are asymptomatic till valve area reaches 2 square centimeter. Almost all the cases of mitral stenosis is rheumatic in origin, and usually the valve is calcified, but massive calcification is quite rare. Congenital MS is also rare, and other etiologies of mitral stenosis can be mitral annular calcification, which is also quite rare. The female is to male ratio is 2:1 in case of mitral stenosis. So what happens in mitral stenosis? There's an obstruction to the LA emptying, so the LV filling decreases, so the forward cardiac output comes down, and since the LA doesn't empty completely, there's an increased LA pressure leading on to increased LA size, which can ultimately cause atrial fibrillation. The increased LA pressure in turn increases the pulmonary venous pressure and the pulmonary artery pressure, which can lead on to pulmonedema and RV failure. So LV is usually normal, but you can have decreased LV ejection fraction in 1/3 of the MS patients. The reason being rheumatic carditis or chronic volume underloading. Concomitant CAD is another important cause for decreased LV function in these patients, especially if the age is more than 40, and there are other risk factors for CAD. Pulmonary hypertension leading on to septal hypertrophy and RV dysfunction can lead on to LV dysfunction in these cases as well. So the RV function is normal if pulmonary artery hypertension doesn't develop, but ultimately severe pulmonary hypertension develops in these patients, and when these patients present to us, most of them already have the PA pressures of more than 30 to 40 millimeters of mercury, and this can result in RV failure. And most important thing is that RV failure can lead on to LV failure. So this is a picture summarizing the pathophysiology of mitral stenosis. What happens to the pressure volume loop? The stroke volume.